Good morning, one and all. This is Dr. Pranay Dutte, and today in this video, we will see about the basalt and its related rocks. So, as a part of your igneous petrology, in the previous lecture, what we seen about the in petrology, what is the petrology is nothing but a study of rocks. Petrology is nothing but a study of rocks and a different type of process in a formation of igneous rock. So in petrology, you see that three different type of rocks are there. Basically, igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock. These are three different type of rocks are there: igneous rock, metamorphic rock, and sedimentary rock. In this three type of rock, there is a three different processes has been involved. Okay, igneous petrology, the igneous processes, sedimentary process, and metamorphic processes. So now in the past few lecture, we see about a different kind of a structure which is formed by the igneous rock, like we have a batholith and dike, and what is the seeds and all. Again, the later we see about the ophiolite. What the ophiolite is all about? What the what is the different kind of suit or different kind of complex structure that is a ophiolite has been formed? So that we all are already seen in some previous lecture about the ophiolites and all, and we also seen that there is a different type of classification is applied to the igneous rock, like what intrusive igneous rock, extrusive igneous rock, and hyperbasal igneous rock. So what is the intrusive? Intrusive is which you cool down under the surface. That is your intrusive igneous rock. The rock which is cools above or form above the surface, that is the extrusive rock. Whereas the hyperbasal rock is in between that, or up to 2 kilometer, whatever the rock is formed, that is your what we can say the rock, your hyperbasal rock. So this is three different type of rocks. They are having some equivalent, like the composition is same. Which composition? A mineralogical composition is same. So mineralogical composition is involved. Mineralogical composition for the rock which is having an intrusive rock, the rock which is having an extrusive rock, is the same one. Talking here about the grain, the concept is coming into the sedimentary rock when we study the sedimentary rock. But the crystal size for this one is a difference. The crystal size for this all the intrusive igneous rock is a difference. So now in this lecture, what we are going to see about the basalt. One of the igneous rock, okay, basalt is one of the igneous rock. We are going, so basalt and granite, we mostly study these two different type of rock in scenario for the Indian condition, because we get the granite and basalt very often in an Indian situation, Indian condition. So most of your the central India terrain, the central Indian terrain is mostly occupied by the basalts. So this is now you have a basalt for you. So what is the definition of basalt? Basalt is a basaltic rock, is a volcanic rock that is characterized by the presence of clinopyroxene and plagioclase as well as mineral. Olivine, orthopyroxene, and silica rich glass may be present as a accessory mineral along with the iron oxide. A basaltic rock is a volcanic rock. Okay, so first of all, what is the where the basalt is formed? So it is a volcanic rock. Okay, you know that there is some intrusive rock are there, extrusive rock are there, hyperbasal. So it is a volcanic rock, means it's formed above with the presence of a clinopyroxene. The presence of clinopyroxene and plagioclase. So which type of mineral, which type of what we can say the mineral is the mostly essential for this or which one is the part of this basalt? The basalt is having a two major mineral type which should be there. Then we can call this as a basalt. One is a clinopyroxene, one is plagioclase. So plagioclase is what? Plagioclase feldspar. Plagioclase is what? Plagioclase feldspar. So clinopyroxene and your plagioclase feldspar is an essential mineral for your basalt. Then you have olivine, orthopyroxene and silica rich glass, which is may be present as an accessory mineral along with the iron oxide. Olivine, orthopyroxene and silica rich glass may be present as your accessory mineral along with the iron oxide. So this is what your different kind of what we can say the basaltic rock. This one is in third picture we have a columnar basalt. In third picture we have a columnar basalt. In first one we have the first one is known as the vesicular basalt. So this all this different type of basalts are present there. This is a different type of basalts are present there. Different type of basalt is having a different type of structure in it, and this structure can represent a different processes. Means within a basalt also we have a different kind of processes which is operating in a different conditions. So what this picture is showing you a different kind of basaltic composition, different kind of basaltic composition. So first one is the vesicular basalt. First one is the vesicular basalt. When there is any gases are there, when there any gases are there, that gases can form your what we can say the vesicles. The gases can form your vesicles, and that vesicles is when form that vesicles and cavities when filled by the some secondary mineral, that is known as the amygdaloid or basalt. When that vesicles is formed by the some of the secondary mineral, that is known as the amygdaloidal basalt. Then you have a column-like structure. Which form, that is known as your columnar basalt. And this is fourth one is your simple, we can call it as a basalt. The basalt is also having a different kind of classified on the basis of their process and how they are formed. There is a three type of texture which is basalt is having. Size, shape and arrangement of the texture of the basalt is nothing but a size, shape and arrangement of the mineral that is present in the rock. That is your texture, size, shape and arrangement of the rock. So three type of texture are very common. One is ophiotic texture, that is a lance-shaped plagioclase included in a larger pyroxene. Sub-ophiotic texture, here you have a pyroxene that is smaller. Then you have a porphyritic texture. Here we have a phenocryst in a fine ground mass, that is a olivine basalt. So three type of texture are very common. Ophiotic texture, lance shape, that is a lance shaped plagioclase included in a larger pyroxene. Then you have a sub-ophiotic texture, here the pyroxene are very smaller. Then you have a porphyritic texture. So ophiotic, sub-ophiotic and porphyritic, this is the three different type of texture we have: ophiotic, sub-ophiotic and porphyritic. So the ophiotic texture are lance-shaped plagioclase that is included in a larger pyroxene. Sub-ophiotic are pyroxene are smaller there, and you have a phenocryst which is coarser in a fine ground mass. So this is a different three different type of texture of basalt. You can see this one microscopic photograph. If you take lead-shaped plagioclase, you can see in the first image lead-shaped plagioclase, or in fourth also you can see somehow. So lead is a nothing but a, oh, this is a plagioclase lead. Whatever the gray color material you can have, this is a lead shape. This one, this is a lead shape plagioclase which you have. In ophiotic texture, that is lead shape. Sub-ophiotic, pyroxene are smaller. So here you can see the pyroxene are smaller. Then the you have a porphyritic. Phenocryst is in a fine round. This one is a phenocryst, a very large phenocryst, which is seen in a, or which can be a part of in a large. Then what is the global abundance of the basalt? Global abundance of basalt. So where you can have a basalt when you have a basalt in a world? You have a basalt at mid oceanic ridges. At mid-oceanic ridges, you have a basalt. Then you have in ocean island. Then on a orogenic continental margin and island arcs. Then you have a continental plates. So most of the model of mantle melting is based mostly on the study of basalt. So basalt is a very what we can say the abundantly found rock. Okay, most of the oceanic ridges or oceanic island is having composed of the, or what is the composition of this one is a basalt. So that's how also you have a important of basalt. Where it is formed? It forms at the mid oceanic ridges. Basalt is formed at the mid oceanic ridges. So that basalt is known as the mid oceanic ridges basalt, MORB. That is known as mid oceanic ridges basalt, that is a MORB. Then you have oceanic island. Then you have oceanic island. That is known as oceanic island basalt again. So oceanic island basalt is OIB. Then you have orogenic continental margin and island arcs. Then you have orogenic continental margin and island arc associated with the subduction zone. Then you have bimodal volcanic along with the andesite. Bimodal volcanics along with the andesite. Then you have a fourth one is a continental plate. Fourth one is a continental plate, which is not associated with the subduction, plume or rifting related activity. So fourth one you have a continental plate. Fourth one you have a continental plate, which is not associated with the subduction. Which is not associated with the subduction. The most abundant igneous rock type and hence most well studied experimentally and in the field are basalt. So most of the model of the mantle is melting is based on the mostly the study of basalt. So whatever the study we are going through, whatever the different kind of study we are going through, that all studies are mostly concentrated on a basalt. Most of the studies are concentrated on a basalt. There are number of compositional variation in a basalt resulting in their wide variety. There are number of compositional variation in basalt which is resulting in their wide variety. So Yorder and Tille, two scientists, Yorder and Tille, recognize the importance of representing principal magma type in terms of simple basalt system and introduce the concept of basalt tetrahedron. Yorder and Tille recognize the importance of representing principal magma type in terms of simple basalt system and introduce the concept of basalt tetrahedron. According to them, faces in the quaternary system that is diopside, posterite, nepheline and quartz contain the principal component of all the major and common mineral in a basalt group. according to Yorder and Tillet, phases in a quaternary system. Phases in a quaternary system, that is diopside, posterite, and quartz, contain the principal component of all the major and common mineral in a basalt group. Then you have a basalt tetrahedron. Then you have a basalt tetrahedron. The tetrahedron is dissected by two planes, that is plane 1 diopside, diopside albite, and instatite about pyroxene, one of the pyroxene group. So plane 2 is diopside. So this is the two different planes where you have a tetrahedron silica. Then you have a different kind of basalt. It's not like that you have only one basalt type there. So you have a different type of basalt. The two planes of dividing the two planes that divide basalt into five unique groups on basis of normative component, and the two different planes divide a basalt into the five unique group on basis of normative component. So first one is the quartz tholylite. First one is the quartz tholylite. Second one is the hyperstene tholylite. First one is the quartz tholylite. Second one is the hyperstene tholylite. Third one is the olivine tholylite. Fourth one is the olivine basalt. Fifth one is the alkali olivine basalt or alkaline basalt. So this is the five different type of basalt. This is the five different type of basalt we have. So first one is the quartz tholylite. The quartz tholylite is characterized by normative quartz. Quartz tholylite is characterized by a normative quartz and hyperstene. Quartz tholylite is characterized by normative quartz and hyperstene. Then you have a hyperstene tholylite. Then you have a hyperstene tholylite. The hyperstene tholylite is characterized by normative hyperstene but no quartz there. Okay, so quartz is the main thing to do have. Quartz is the main things to do have. So different type of basalt we are now studied. So first one is the quartz tholylite, which is oversaturated. What is the oversaturated? So you have a quartz and hyperstene there. So you, that's called as the oversaturated. Saturated is when you don't have any quartz, that is your saturated. Undersaturated, you have most of the things are olivine and hyperstene. That is your undersaturated. That is called as the olivine tholylite. Then you have a undersaturated, that is the olivine basalt, which is having a normative olivine but no hyperstene, which is having a normative olivine but no hyperstene. Fifth one is the alkali olivine basalt or alkaline basalt, normative olivine and nepheline. Then most of the basalt except in those containing normative asymmetric are representing in a basalt tetrahedron. So in last lecture we see that one. This is a basalt tetrahedra where you have a different kind of composition, nepheline, clinopyroxene and all. So this is a tholylitic group of basalt. What is the saline aspect of the basalt compositional type? What is the saline option of the basalt compositional type? So quartz tholylite and hyperstene tholylite are combinedly called subalkaline basalts. Quartz tholylite and hyperstene tholylites are combinedly called the subalkaline basalts. They are widely manifested by continental flood basalt. Proveniens and volcanic arcs. However, both this region also consist of subordinate alkali olivine basalt. Olivine basalt and alkali olivine basalt are commonly called as alkali basalt or alkaline basalt. Alkali basalt and alkaline basalt. A majority of MOB and OFB are your what we can say are olivine tholylite. That all are the olivine tholylite. Then you have a strongly alkaline basalt. That you have a strongly alkaline basalt that is having a nepheline characterized many ocean island. Olivine tholylite are described as a transitional basalt as they contain both the normative hypostene and olivine. Then you have a tholylitic alkali basalt are major magma type in a nature. So you have a alkali versus tholylitic basalt. You have a alkali versus tholylitic basalt, which is having a composition of tholylites, alkaline. So you have a tholylite, alkaline. So alkali versus tholylite basalt, what is the difference between alkali and tholylite basalt? What is the difference between alkali and tholylite basalt? So the only difference is you have olivine is present as a phenocrystal phase. In alkaline basalt, you have both the phase, both the phenocryst as well as the ground mass. Potash feldspar absent in tholylite. Whereas in alkaline basalt, there is some minor phases of the ground mass is available or of the potash feldspar. Then you have a plagioclase feldspar. So you have abundant calcic varieties. You have abundant calcic varieties of the labradorite. The abundant of labradorite to andesite. This is a different kind of basalt. Then you have a pyroxene. Pyroxene is nothing but the augite plus augite or subcalcic augite as a phenocryst. Augite is a subcalcic augite as a phenocryst. Then alkaline basalt is a titaniferous. Then you have opaque oxide minerals. Which is a titanomagnetite or titanomagnetite with the ilmenite. Tholylitic basalt are titanomagnetite and titanomagnetite with the ilmenite. So this is your alkaline basalt. Then nodules are peridotite nodules absent there in tholylite, whereas alkaline basalt is having a occasionally in alkaline basalt you have occasionally found nodules. Then you have vesicles, silica minerals and analcite or zeolite filling. So this is your vesicles. Then you have a calcic alkaline. Or alkaline in a subcline. So this is a triangular diagram which present our. So basalt magmatism in relation to the plate tectonic environment. So how the basalt is get what we can say the magmatized in a relation to the plate tectonic relation. Basalt are universal and are found in almost every tectonic environment based on the major element and trace element discrimination. Basalt geochemistry can be used to reconstruct paleotectonic setting such as a construction strictly implied applied to a Phanerozoic setting only, even though the operation of what we can say the plate tectonic in the Precambrian time is now better understood. Three major magma series are recognized and have a distinct contribution when they consider in terms of plate tectonic: tholylites, calcic alkaline and alkaline. So basalt in terms of their composition and this on all are universal. They are found in almost every tectonic environment, whether the subduction plate boundary, whether the divergent plate boundary, whether all these plate boundaries. So basalt is a universal and it is found almost in every tectonic environment based on the major element. Based on the major element, trace element discrimination, basalt geochemistry can be used to reconstruct paleotectonic setting. such a reconstruction strictly apply to Phanerozoic setting only, even through the operation of plate tectonic in a pre-Cambrian time, is now better understood. Three major magma series are recognized and have a distinct distribution when considered in terms of plate tectonic, that is pholiolites, calcareous alkaline and alkaline. So then you have basalt magmatism, and you have basalt magmatism which is in a plate tectonic setting, so you have plate margin setting and within a plate setting, a plate margin setting and within a plate setting, these two different kind of settings are there. So you have a diverging, environment, diverging tectonic environment, and you have a different kind of environment. So in diverging environment, that is your oceanic ridge, back arc basin. In diverging environment, you have oceanic ridge, that is back arc basin. A converging environment, that is a subduction. A converging environment, that is your subduction, which is a island arc active continental margin. Island arc active continental margin. Then you have an intra-oceanic plate. Intracontinental plate. So this is a plate margin and within a plate setting where you have a basalt magnetism. So when you have a two different plates which move from each other, so that is your divergent plate boundary. There you form a oceanic ridge. In case of subduction, you have a island arc. In the plate setting, interior plate setting, you have a oceanic island, you have a continental flood basalt. Then continental flood basalt and continental drift zone. This is a two different kind of things are there. So magma series are tholiolites. Basalt, N-morph, P-morph, T-morph, and so this is a P-morph. N-morph is a depleted one. P-morph means enriches. T is a transitional. So different kinds of magma and their basalts are recognized. Then you have some saline point on basalt tectonic setting. So tholiolites of a divergent margin are very poor in a potash compared to those in a convergent margin. Or in a continental plate setting. Morph are purest basalt and are least modified and have a restricted range of composition, that is your MgO, low KTO content and all. So morphs are nothing but purest basalt which are least modified and have restricted range of composition. SiO2 is 50% to 50.93. then you have MgO, then you have uniformly low potassium oxide, that is KTO content, that is 0.14 to 0.17. this is your purest basalt at the morph condition. What is a morph? A mid-oceanic ridge basalt is your morph. So at the least modify, have a restricted range of composition. Then you have morph are classified into three different types: N-morph, P-morph and T-morph. N-morph is a depleted, the normal morph. P-dot morph is a enriched plum morph. T-morph is a transitional morph. N-morph, P-morph and T-morph, this is the three different type of morph which we present. First two members are principal end members and their third one is an intermediate. There is a compositional gradient between them. So you have a different kind of saline feature of this one, that how the morph has been classified. The morph has been classified on the basis of their percentage. So So this is how your all the mid-oceanic basalt, this is how your mid-oceanic basalt, ridge basalt is having a ridge system in the world. So you can see there is a ridge, that is a mid-Atlantic ridge, East Pacific rise you have, in a Pacific also you have a ridge, then South Indian Oceanic ridge. So you can see there is a different kind of ridges are there. Different kind of ridge are there. So that all are the mid-oceanic ridge system. So NMOB versus EMOB. What is the NMOB? What is the EMOB? The NMOB is an incompatible ridge and incompatible poor mantle source region for the MORB magma. Incompatible ridge and incompatible poor mantle source region for the MORB magma. NMOB is a normal MOB that is a taps the depleted upper mantle source. NMOB is a taps the depleted upper mantle source, that is known as your NMOB, that is a normal MOB. Then you have a EMOB. Then you have a EMOB. EMOB is enriched in a MOB, which is also called as a PMOB or a plume. Taps the deeper fertile mantle. EMOB is a enriched MOB, which also called as a PMOB or plume, which taps the deeper fertile and mantle. This is the REE diagram for the NMOB and EMOB. This is the REE diagram for NMOB and EMOB. This is the petrogenesis of basalt. This is the petrogenesis of basalt. So now we now know about how the basalt is going into the surface and how the this classification of different kind of basalt and all. Now the thing is that how the magma is formed for the basaltic, especially basaltic magma. We also call this magma as a basalt magma because this one is mostly studied by the magma is studied by the 2 to 3 different type of rocks or the depending upon the viscosity. So melting of eclogite. So melting of eclogite is the same range of composition as basalt. Melting of eclogite is the same range of composition as basalt. High pressure metamorphism equivalent of basalt. High pressure. So the high pressure metamorphism are equivalent of basalt. And whereas same range of compositional as basalt. This is a melting of eclogite. Then you have a peridotite melting. Then you have a peridotite melting. So nodules brought up by the basalt are pyritic in composition. They are pyritic in composition. So that is known as your this is a lurzolite as a possible source of basalt genesis. This is a lurzolite. So lurzolite is nothing but a percentage or combination of Al2O3 plus TiO. Al2O3 plus TiO2, you form a somewhere middle your lurzolite. Lurzolite is a probably fertile unaltered mantle. Lurzolite is nothing but a fertile unaltered mantle. So dunite and herzbergite are refractory residuum. Dunite and herzbergite are refractory residuum after the basalt that has been extracted by partially melting. Dunite and herzbergite are the refractory residuum after the basalt which has been extracted by the partial melting. This is the typical lurzolite, which is a type of peridotite with olivine is highest. Then your ortho and clinopyroxene. So olivine here you can see the olivine, you can see there one is olivine, orthopyroxene and clinopyroxene. So lurzolite, in lurzolite what happened, the orthopyroxene is the highest one. Orthopyroxene is the highest one. Then you have a clinopyroxene, then you have olivine. So olivine is the highest in this one, followed by the orthopyroxene and clinopyroxene. Where is the ortho or where is the this what we can say the olivine, this upper side is olivine, you can have an olivine vestrite. This is after the IUGS, International Union of Geological Society. Then you have a experiment of enrich, experiment of depleted mental sample are depleted mental sample are polylytic easily creature by are created by the 10 to 30% of partial melting. So this is a depleted. When the mental is depleted, depleted in what? Depleted in some elements. The tholylytic are more silica saturated at lower pressure. So grades toward the alkali. So when you have a depleted mental, when you have a depleted mental, you can have a more, what we can say, the more tholylytic basalt, which is easily created by 10 to 30% of partial melting. Result of partial melting experiment on the depleted lherzolite and dashed line are contour representing percent, that is a partial melt produced. Strongly curved line are the contour of the normative olivine contained of the melt, that is orthopyroxene and chloropyroxene. So this is what represent the degree of melting at which this faces. Enriched mental is tholylytic or what we can extend to the tholylytic rock, tholylytic rock. Then you have spilites. Then you have spilites. What is mean by spilites and how it can be studied? What is mean by spilite and how it can be studied? We will going to see this one. What is the spilite and what is the how we can going to see this one? So the spilite is a basic lava. Spilite is a basic lava in which plagioclase and in albite, a plagioclase in and what we can say the albite, instead of normal labradorite and which were chloride, partially or completely take place of the normal ferromagnesium mineral. So they typically occur lava. They are typically occur as a submarine lava flow, often as a pillow lava. The pillow lava are typically zoned with margin and four different in a composition. Then vesicles are abundant and filled with the fluorite and calcite. There is no dike of seeds. There is no dike. of spite are known. They are restricted in their distribution and mostly found in the pre-organic sediment and organic belt. Recent spite are found in the Morb and Indian Ocean. This is your spilites. Spilite is originated. Origination of spilite is a controversial one because there is always been a two groups of people be always showing that yes, spilite is originated from these places or I am the originator or inventor. Other one is showing the other interest group. So there is a controversial statement about the origin of the spilite. Then you have crystallized from primary spilitic magma. Then you have crystallized from primary spilitic magma. Derived from a basic magma, that is a assimilated seawater. So basalt diagenetically altered or metasomatized after the European. Then you have an Indian example, that is a Deccan trap lower Kadapa igneous rock. So Deccan trap, I already explained what is the Deccan trap. Tekka trap is nothing but a volcanic what you have ultramafic lava. Now the second one is the comatite. In the first one we see the second one is the comatite. So what is the comatite? A comatite is a ultramafic lava which is restricted almost to the Precambrian. There are ultramafic lava restricted almost to the Precambrian. They were first described from the Barbitron Mountain are the in South Africa. They are the first one to describe the comatite. So what is the comatite? Is the ultramafic rock, and those with the more than 18% of the MgO are called comatite. So what is the definition of comatite? The definition of comatite is when you have more than 80%, that is known as comatite. They were first described by the Barbitron Mountain in Barbitron Mountain in South Africa. Two type of comatite are distinct. Those with the 18% of MgO. 18% of MgO, that is called as a comatite. Those with the more less than 80% of containing more than 10% of MgO, it is called as a comatitic basalt. Otherwise, it is also only called a comatite. But at this one, you have a comatitic basalt. So they show a characteristic texture. You show a characteristic texture known as a spintex texture. So when you have comatite that is present in a Archean and a greenstone belt, southern India, only post Archean comatite and that of a Godavari basin. So which visual restriction of comatite to early Precambrian implies thermal regime necessary to high degree of partial melting no longer existence. Since the density of comatite is so high, they could not rise through the continental crust even if they did still deep still even. So this is all about Kimber. What we can say, the basalt, not kimberlite, is a part of basalt. So you have a spilite and comatite. These two are the different type of your basalt, different features. So this is what we are already all study in this PPT about what is the different type of volcanic rock, what is the basalt. What is the reason behind studying the basalt? This is the objective of this lecture also. And this basalt is nothing but a igneous rock. This is some of the photograph I already show you this photo. The lighter, columnar and basalt. Texture is know that you are all rounder. And so the plagioclase lath you can have. This is also plagioclase, so you can have a different kind of texture. That is a ophiolitic, sub-ophiolitic, and porphyritic. So where you find this one mostly in a. Then you have continental plates. Classification of basalt, how you can classify it on the basis of mineralogical composition. Then you have a different kind of क्लाइनोपाइरोक्सिन, क्लाइनोपाइरोक्सिन एंड क्लाइनोपाइरोक्सिन. सो दिस ऑल थ्री आर द क्लाइनोपाइरोक्सिन, द पार्ट ऑफ क्लाइनोपाइरोक्सिन. एंड दिस इज सेलाइन फीचर ऑफ बसाल्ट. दिस इज हाउ यू कैन कंपेयर विद द अल्कली बसाल्ट एंड द होलिक थोलिनाइट बसाल्ट. Basalt magnetism in relation to the basalt magnetism in relation to the plate on tectonic environment. So this is a different, so where it is formed mostly in a mob and all this reason, that's why it is studied in the mid-oceanic region. This system, this is your what we can say the slightly different kind of study. Is a different kind of. So this is all from the today's lecture about the what we can see the basalt and its type, basalt and its type, or how the basalt has been formed, how the different rocks has been formed, and how you can identify and what is the pedo lava structure and all. So this one all we study under this section, that is your elementary physical and structural geology. May this one is also helpful you in a future GATE and that exams, or what is the unconformity and what is the basalt and all. So this question is very useful for the this purpose. So thank you for listening, and hope you understand the topic. Thank you for